Folks, today we have a 7-round workout. It begins with 15 GHD sit-ups, then you move to 15 back extensions, then that's followed up with 10 thrusters and 10 clean and jerks, and those are each at 95 pounds for the ladies and 135 for the guys. This is a beast of a workout, and if you look back to when this originally premiered on CrossFit.com, you'll see times upwards of 25 to 35 minutes originally. So this is not meant to be a sprint. When we're looking at this workout, the first thing to think about is the stated goal of CrossFit.com workouts, which is that they are intended to exceed over time the capacities of even the world's fittest athletes. This workout certainly fits that bill. That means that there's really only a small percentage of the athletes out there that will probably be doing this workout as it's written, and that's completely fine. CrossFit.com workouts, like all good CrossFit workouts, are designed specifically to be scaled back to meet the fitness levels of the athletes that are doing them. And this is going to be one that I would certainly scale myself. Some ways we can think about that. We want to scale the volume in this workout, because if you do the math on that, there's a lot of stuff going on in here. To scale that the volume, the first thing I would probably do is shorten the number of rounds you're doing. So keep the repetitions within each round, but instead of doing 5 rounds, maybe know that going in that you're going to do only 5. After that, we can look at scaling the load. So 135 pounds for the guys on the thruster might be a lot. Maybe we scale that down to 105, 115, 95. For the clean and jerk, we just keep the same barbell so we don't have to worry about going back and forth on that. And we kind of move through the workout with that intention. This is also a workout where equipment might be an issue. So if you look at the GHD, and if you've got a class full of 10 people and only one GHD, well, how do we attack that? One of the ways that I like to approach workouts like this is to have them share equipment. So maybe the first round, we start off with the GHD with some of our athletes, and then after that, they move to an ab mat sit-up, and then they alternate back and forth in those rounds between. So if you do the GHD sit-ups, then you do the GHD back extensions. If you do an ab mat sit-up, then maybe we do like a banded good morning instead of the back extension, so we can still keep the basic stimulus going in there. That allows us to still get the movements that we're trying to get. It still allows us to get the stimulus of the workout and kind of keep moving through that thing. But ultimately, this workout is going to be one that you kind of want to work through in chunks. The midline stuff at first has to get taken care of, and then it's just about holding onto that barbell on the thruster, trying not to break it up too much, and then probably fast singles on that clean and jerk so that you can get through the workout before tomorrow comes. Enjoy.